It's time to break out the LDAT again and take a look at input latency for 60fps and 120fps between GeForce Now and Shadow. Let's get into it. What's up, Cloud Gamers? Welcome back to the Cloud Gaming Extreme channel, and today we're taking a look at input latency between GeForce Now and Shadow. We'll have some 60fps and 120fps to look at in four different games, and for a couple of those, we'll have my local latency as well, just for an idea of how things are going. Now, we do have a more full overview of what the LDAT is and how that works in our previous LDAT video on the channel, so definitely check that out if you haven't already. Now, let's go ahead and get into the games and what kind of results we've got. So the first game we'll start with is Apex Legends, and I've said before this game is one of the best when it comes to testing for latency. It has phenomenal input latency, both for local and for cloud, especially for GeForce Now. Getting into the results, my round trip delay for Shadow and GeForce Now is identical. They both bounce between 15 and 20 milliseconds. For Shadow at 60fps, we're at 84.1 milliseconds on input. And at 120fps, we're 71.9. Shadow comes in at 71.5 for their 60 and 46 milliseconds for their 120, which basically matches my local 60Hz at 46.8 and my 120 is 28.2. And these are phenomenal scores all around, but I did expect that higher score for Shadow being a full virtual PC versus the more optimized experience that GeForce Now is trying to give you, which kind of answers some of the question that people are always asking, why doesn't GeForce Now just let you get access to a full-blown PC? And virtual PCs are a little bit of a different beast, and I don't think they'd be able to quite get the same kind of input latency yet with those that they're able to obtain with GeForce Now. So really interesting with that for Apex Legends. Now let's move over and take a look at Destiny 2. Now, Destiny 2 is an interesting one because on Shadow, with the current hardware, you can't hardly run the game over 60fps no matter what to begin with. So I couldn't match 120fps like I could on GFN or local, which is why you don't see as much of a difference between 60 and 120 up here on Shadow at 97.1 milliseconds for 60fps and 90.9 for 120. We got a slight improvement because of the increase in the stream, but the game was running the same FPS. But GFN had some great scores at 79.5 for 60 and 59.7 for 120. My local was 60.2 at 60 and 38.7 at 120Hz. Not near as good as Apex Legends input latency, but pretty good. And of course, GFN still offering some of the best latency in cloud when it comes to Destiny and Apex Legends. Shadow struggling a bit, but again, a lot of that's because it also cannot run the game at the FPS that GFN or my local machine could. And next up, we have Bright Memory Infinite, a game that's a lot of fun, if albeit very short, but it's a great game to test latency. It's also not optimized to have the greatest input latency. So taking a look at Shadow, we had 100.1 milliseconds at 60fps, which was pretty high for me. At 120fps, though, we had 85.7 milliseconds, which was more playable, much like GFN's 83.6 milliseconds at their 60fps. But GFN's 120fps got me down to 52.6 milliseconds on my average here, and was a much better experience when playing through Bright Memory Infinite. So let's jump over and take a look at the Crysis Remaster. Now, the Crysis Remaster was kind of a bonus. I only tested this game at 120fps on Shadow because I didn't think I was going to use it, but then I decided I did want to put it in here as context to take a look at things. So for Shadow at 120fps, we had 71.7 milliseconds for our input latency, which was okay. But over on GFN, still in those 50s, we had 55.9 milliseconds at 120fps, which was great for input latency. And you kind of see the story with GFN when it comes to latency. Same thing in our past video. At their 60Hz, though, we had 84.3, so Shadow kind of fell in between the 60 and the 120 there when it came to their input latency. So what does all this mean? Well, let's get into some final thoughts. So with this particular test, I wanted to take a look at a cloud PC full-blown like Shadow that gives me the same round-trip ping and compare that to GFN, which has a more narrowed down, slimmed down approach to try to get you the best gaming experience you can get and takes away the full cloud PC experience. And I knew Shadow would have higher latency. Now, Shadow for me is still one of my best cloud PC experiences, and it does offer great input latency for me, and I can play just about anything on there. But GFN's 3080 tier obviously beats that by a lot, especially in most games. So for me, it continues to be true that GeForce Now offers the best experience when it comes to cloud, when it comes to your input latency and your image quality. There can be an argument made for content right now when it comes to cloud gaming, but when it comes to quality and input latency, GeForce Now has it, especially if you're looking at the difference between cloud PCs and cloud gaming services. All right, guys, thanks a lot, as always, for coming to check out the video. If you haven't already, subscribe, give us a like on the video, ring the bell so you know when new content comes out, and leave us your comment down below. Thanks again, and we'll see you guys in the next one.